Welcome, and here we are recording some keyboards for the new Headspace record. I am here with nobody. Brilliant. I'm on my own. Well, I say on my own. I have my. I'm here for the day. I have got my lunch here. I'm going to be giving too much of a plug to Waitrose, but char-grilled Mediterranean vegetable soup, which is fantastic. I'm going to try this roasted vegetable lasagna, which I'm not buying it because it's low calorie. I'm buying it because it was a third off and I'm a cheapskate. So, got 12 tracks and I started yesterday recording the keys on the first track, which has a working title of Savile Row, which certainly won't be called Savile Row. It was just purely something that was mentioned, I think, on the radio when Pete and I were on our way here writing it. Yes, very happy to have my new Focal Twin speakers here. Anybody's remotely interested? Which sound fantastic. And the sub down there, which should pretty much get as many complaints as possible from the people in the offices across the road. Got the Kronos X here as well, which is very cool. Just picked that up the other day. Exchanged out my older Kronos for the X, which is great. Very happy with that. And not much else has really changed in here since the last little bit of video. The Moog is out over there, and I also have a managed to pretty much get all my equipment back now from a lot of it's been over in America at Aussie Storage Place from various tours over there. So now have my SV1 back here, which will be recording later as well, and probably a bit of the old Fender Rhodes Mark 1, which has been gathering dust for a little while. And then I've got this little beauty, which was a gift from Mr. Lee Pomeroy, which I borrowed a long time ago, and I actually used on the first kind of Headspace promo EPs that we did. There were a couple of tunes, one called Wasted Apology, which featured this little Gen synth, this little SX1000. This particular one as well has a lovely feature of when you get up to the top octave here, it drops down two octaves. So if you're doing an arpeggio, for example, you end up sounding like you're doing it with two hands. It's very strange. Obviously a fault, but you know, quite a nice fault to have. That's about it, really. I'm obviously not going to be playing you any of the music yet, because that will all be coming in August, all being well. I've got Damien Wilson here next week, starting to record some vocals, so we're going to get some video footage there, and I'm sure he'll be on fine form. So that's it for me. I'm going to start recording and stop nattering. So I've got a lot of my gear back now as well, as I was saying earlier, and I'll take you downstairs and show you the storage area. So this is where all my shit ends up. It's my Hammond here, under more shit. Oh, not the Yamaha, that's not shit, it's very good, the XS8. And a few guitars piled up. Whenever I need anything, it always takes me about half a day to find it. Later on tomorrow, I'm going to be moving some of that shit and playing the old Hammond. I've got the Leslie in there, Leslie 145. Obviously won't be using any guitars on Headspace stuff, because Pete will kill me if I start putting guitars on anything. He's more than capable of doing that. So, right, back to it. I'm going to record a bit of piano now on the Nord. I'll just play through a bit of it, and you can have a listen. So during the writing kind of development stage of tracks, this particular song is called Fatty Hoodoo. It's not the title that's going to be on the album, clearly. It's a stupid title. It was I've got a dog called Hoodoo, and Hoodoo is very fat, so that seemed to stick for the time being. This particular section of the song is very, just very piano heavy, and during the writing stage. It was just kept very basic so that Damien can work out his melodies and stuff like that. It's more about getting the chord structure right and the time changes between the chords. So on the actual sort of demo, it was all very just straight. So I'm just practicing, sort of flowering up a little bit really. So I'm not going to play the rest of the track because obviously you'll hear the melody and all the rest of it. But I'll play through the chords. Structure and yeah, I'll probably play for it a few more times, try and get rid of the wrong notes and then record it. Another favourite piece of kit has made its way up here for some recording on the new stuff. This is the Little Fatty by Moog, of course, and featured heavily on the I Am Anonymous album and is also going to be featured heavily on this. This tune at the minute, the one with the working title of Fatty Hoodoo, which talking to Pete earlier reminded me that originally it was called Honey Boo Boo, which is the name of a young beauty pageant contestant in America. Dreadful television programme, if anybody's seen it. And rather than call it Honey Boo Boo, we went with Fatty Hoodoo, which is obviously my dog, who is marginally overweight. So using this, just to double a couple of lines. Kind of very typical sort of moody sound, just change a few little parameters on here. I love this machine because you can just get really hands-on, move the glide rate, the portability. Resonance. Cut-off filter, it's brilliant. It's so cool. I use it on loads of stuff actually. I used it on Aussie for a while. And I will continue to use it on here if I can stop making these stupid fucking videos and get my arse into gear and record something. Right, time to set up for a bit of Hammond recording. Got a couple of these PG81s, these Shure kind of overhead condenser mics, which go on the top, and then one of these to go on the bass end. So yeah, show you what I'm doing here. So I've got the two of those at the top of the Leslie, that down the bass to get the sub, and very important you have it next to a microwave. It really does help the sound no end if it's next to that. Hammond's over here. I would actually like a little bit more room in here, but that's not going to happen with all this shit still in here.
Maybe I have been attracted to the city as a child. It was a heart of community, unified, healthy, sharp, abbreviated. Opportunities in the city, greater for the choices of success and happiness, acceptable completeness. I moved there as a teenager.